c'est la même chose.
Ouais, c'est la même chose.
Ils ont déjà des mots échangeurs. Tamam. Tamam. Tamam, ça veut dire genre d'accord. Hein?
Well, I told you, speak English around me, bro.
Shut up, yeah.
He was actually part of the World Cup squad, so he's got a runners-up medal from 2006. You know, so he's rubbed shoulders with the likes of Henri, Ribéry, Zinedine Zidane, you know, like world-class player.
Finish, finish! Oh, yes, sir.
Hello, good morning, God bless. Hope everyone's well. So today's Friday, the day before my trial game. So the plan for today is at PC 39 today, and then I'm just gonna come back and just rest, you know, make sure we eat right. Yeah, just chill out until tomorrow. Do a bit of editing. You know, 'cause that takes forever. Yeah, let's chill out till tomorrow then. So in terms of PC39 and what it is and whatnot, PC39 was, it's kind of formed last season, you know, from a group of free agents, and it's basically PC39 is short for Pascal Chimbonda Academy. For those of you don't know who Pascal Chimbonda is, he's played like hundreds and hundreds of games in the Premier League for Tottenham, for Wigan. I'm sure he played for Blackburn as well. He's played in the Champ, League One, League Two. He's played over in France. He's a French international, so he's made a handful of caps for the national team. He was actually part of the World Cup squad, so he's got a runners-up medal from 2006. You know, so he's rubbed shoulders with the likes of Henri, Ribéry, Zinedine Zidane, you know, like world-class players. So like the knowledge that he passes on when he coaches, you know, it is priceless, you know. It's a good group of lads as well in terms of the players. There's some players that are from France. There's obviously some players that are based up in the Northwest, and obviously some players that travel up, you know. But it's good because they train full-time, you know. 4 days out of five, or 4 days out of seven. It's a good standard, nice pace, good intensity. You know, it's hard work when I go in there. So yeah, man, I'm in there this morning. Obviously, there's usually a games programme. So I remember last season, obviously because of how late the academy started, our games programme, you know, started really in January. Played Macclesfield Town, and then played, which we lost to, but at that point there was different bodies coming in and out of the academy, and then when it was more settled, we played Brentford B team, you know, which was a massive, massive test. I'm gonna leave the link to the highlights of that game in the description, Yeah, we beat Brentford B team 2-1, you know, a team full of professionals and players that get released from, you know, your Cat 1 academies in and around London, so your Chelsea's, your Arsenal's, your Tottenham's, so, you know, it was, and then obviously the season got cut short and whatnot, but, you know, it's a good little setup, and obviously while I don't have a club, you know, it's good to go in there, and even when I do to get a club, you know, it's more than likely going to be part-time, so I'm still going to be going in there, you know, supplementing, you know, what I'm missing out on. I'm going to eat some breakfast, and then I'm going to obviously shower. Then I'll be on my way to Manchester. See you, man, let's go.
le Maghribi.
C'est-à-dire, je suis du bled.
Voilà. Anafi le Maghribi, ce que je t'ai dit là.
C'est la même chose.
C'est la même chose.
Ils ont déjà des mots échangés. Tamam. Tamam. Tamam, ça veut dire genre d'accord.
Hein? I told you, speak English around me, bro.
Shut up, yeah.
I was in goal. PC 39. Let's go. Just about to the end of the session. I think we're going to do some, like a pattern of play and some shooting, so yeah. Hopefully you guys have to see everything, man, but it's snowing, so if the camera gets covered, I'm sorry, guys, I'm really sorry, but yeah. Let's go, man, let's go.
Hey, Nelson!
Hey, good, good!
Come on!
See what you see!
Yeah!
Vinny, Vinny!
Oh!
Allez, touch it! Vinny,
Vinny!
Yes! Yes!
Let's go! Easy, easy! Let's go! Go on,
Nelson! Pull it!
One over!
Get off!
Snowing, it's raining, whatever, sleep, great session. Yeah, man. We're done. All right, picture. Winning team. Come on.
So, yo, people. Just got back from training. Well, not long ago, got back from training. Just had something to eat. And yeah, man, I'm just going to chill out for the rest of the day now. You know, because, as you know, I've got my game tomorrow. I haven't actually played a full 90 minutes since February against Brentford. And then obviously I played like a bit of a game in pre-season. So yeah, it's going to be my first game back since then. I'm actually excited. I can't wait. You know, like I've missed that game day feeling. You know, I've just missed it. You know, the training's nice, but playing a game is, you know, it's a top tier feeling, you know, top tier, you know. So yeah,
I just wanted to talk to you about like how I usually feel before games. So, you know, going back over the years, you know, I've always got nervous before I play the game or before I go and play, you know, for a big opportunity or a big opportunity comes along and I feel so nervous about it. And, you know, number one, it's because I care so much, you know, which is understandable. Like, literally, this is my life. Football is my life. But number two, and this is the most important reason why I've always been nervous, is because like of lack of preparation, you know. So like, I saw a tweet the other day, and you know, the person was tweeting I can't remember exactly word for word what the tweet was, but it was along the lines of, you know, nerves derive from, you know, lack of preparation and being unprepared for a situation, you know. And then I thought to myself, you know what? That's so right, because, you know, go back over the years, like the first time I went into an academy, I was nervous, you know, I wasn't prepared for it. You know, and then all the games I've played since then, like, I do the bare minimum, and the bare minimum is just literally going to training. You know, and go to training, and play a game, you know, and obviously as a kid, as a youth, you can get away with that, but at the age I'm at now, and you know, going into senior football, and the older you get, and the further in the game you wanna go, you can't just rely on, you know, your ability and your raw talent, because that's not enough, because there's other people that are more talented than you, working harder than you, that are less talented than you, catching up with you, working harder than you. So, you know, it's all about being prepared. And one thing I can say that's different between now and then, or even now and, you know, the start of the year, is I'm prepared. You know, I've only shown you guys the past... Well, I've been doing this for a couple of weeks now, so the past couple of weeks, but like, I've been training like this for a long while now, you know, and my mentality towards football has changed, you know. Ever since the first lockdown, I was like, you know what, this is my opportunity to catch up, to catch back up to where I fell behind, and to do this, you know what I mean? You know, and it is a massive, massive opportunity. And the reason why I say that is because, not because of the team, you know, because it's not a massive team, you know, it's a non-league team, but like the thing I'm missing at the moment is game time and stats, clean sheets and all these kind of things. And I feel like that's the final piece to my jigsaw right now, you know, because the thing is, like, I've been kind of working hard and doing all this work and hoping that a manager, you know what, is just going to take a chance on me, you know what I mean? You know what, let's take a chance on him and have a look. And, you know, the likelihood of that happening is so slim. You know, so slim. So I'm going to have to drop down, go and be number one somewhere, and just play. You know, and my talent will speak for itself, kind of thing. I don't have to put out stuff on Twitter, ask people to retweet. I won't have to do all that stuff no more, you know, because my talent is going to speak for itself. And, you know, I will climb, like, and I'm not worried about that no more, you know. Like, I realise, like, I'm confident in myself, and I'm, you know, it's about betting the bank on yourself, it's about risking it all, kind of thing, and that's what I'm kind of doing now. So, like, tomorrow, I don't feel nervous about it at all. Like, as I said, I'm excited, you know, I can't wait for it, you know, just can't wait to stand in the goal and play a game, you know, can't wait to throw myself about, you know, just, I can't wait for it all. Yeah, I'm prepared for this, and I'm ready to do this, you know, like, all those sessions in the trenches, you know, it's preparing you for war, you know, and war is a match day, you know, so, you know, it's finding it nice to have, like a reward, you know, because you train all week, and then to not have the game at the end of it, it's like, oh, and then you train all week again, and no game, and it's like, oh, but now I've trained all week now, and you know, there's a silver lining at the end, you know, which is a game and an opportunity for me to show what I'm about, to go and take someone's shirt, because that's inevitably what I'm going to have to do, you know, is take someone's number one shirt. You know, that's football. So, yeah, man. And I want to share another quote with you, you know, because I ain't trying to be like a philosopher or anything, but, you know, this has stuck with me for a long time, you know. A goalkeeping coach I was with when I was 14, you know, my first ever goalkeeping coach, for a matter of fact. he shared this on Twitter, you know, and it's so, so good. It's obviously, it originates from the Navy SEALs. So it is a, what is it? You know, under pressure, you know, you don't rise to the challenge, you sink to the level of your training, you know, and that made me think, you know, if I look back at all the training I've been doing, you know, is it intense enough? Have I been given 110%, you know, because when you train well, it makes the game so much more straightforward, you know. Football is not a complicated game at all, you know, people overcomplicate football, you know, and players themselves overcomplicate it in their heads, you know, before the game. And I used to be one of those players, you know, you'd overthink it and you think, oh, this, that, blah, blah, blah. And, you know, you don't need to do that, man. It's literally ABC, 1, 2, 3. Do you know what I mean? Like, it's so simple. And I'm not really going to be thinking about the game like that when I go to sleep tonight. I'm just literally going to chill out, edit, watch some Netflix, play some FIFA, you know, get a good night's rest, wake up refreshed, and obviously then tomorrow morning make sure I prepare right, you know, stretch off, form roll, eat the right things, and then go and play, man, and go and enjoy myself, and go and most importantly express myself, you know, because as I keep saying, this is a big opportunity for myself, you know. For so long, like since like June, I've been trying to get a club, you know. I got a new agent, and then I thought I was going somewhere and it didn't work out. And then, you know, now I'm in a situation, you know, we're at the end of 2020, you know, and the season started later, so we're not halfway through the season yet. But, you know, it's getting on, and, you know, time's not stopping. So this is literally my time now to do it, you know. I want to be making a video, you know, not my next video, because my next video is going to be the trial day, but I'm going to be telling you the day after, you know, yep, the manager wants to sign me, you know, all thumbs up, let's go, we're doing it kind of thing, you know. I don't want to be telling you, coming to try and give you an excuse or anything like that, you know, but yeah, man, wish me the best of luck, you know, pray for me, and yeah, man, let's do this, abs in goal, I'll see you tomorrow.